Hi everyone, it's Eleanor from Art with Eleanor, and today I'm going to be showing you how I painted a tiger realistically with acrylic paints. Today I'm going to be painting on a 20 by 25 centimeter canvas, which I prepared with a base of white acrylic paint. I'm using the grid method to transfer the image onto the canvas with an orange pencil, but you can use whatever method works best for you. I start by painting a rough colour blocking layer, which gives a nice base layer for when I want to add texture. I found it easiest to do this from the darkest colour to the lightest colour, and I had to go over some areas twice to neaten up the edges, particularly around the eyes, and to provide enough coverage so that none of the canvas was showing through this base layer. Next was to start on shaping the nose of the tiger by adding a brown colour to the sides of the nose to give more depth in comparison to the yellow ochre base layer. The main challenge of this painting for me was finding the correct technique to use when adding texture to the nose of the tiger. As you might have noticed in the reference photo, the hair on the nose of the tiger is short and gives the appearance of lots of small dots making up the fur rather than longer hair strands as is above the tiger's eyes. This meant that I ended up using a technique called pointillism to add the texture on the nose. This involved adding lots of tiny dots in a range of different shades of brown and yellow ochre to give depth and the correct texture to this part of the nose. As you might imagine, this took quite a while, but personally I think the final effect was worth it. I learned as I went through this painting that I needed to mix up enough paint before starting, as often I would run out of a colour, then forget how I had mixed that colour in the first place. So that added to the length of time it took me to paint this part of the tiger. A lot of this painting I used various wet and wet techniques, as well as dabbing my finger on the canvas to flatten out some of the dots to make them less defined, but it all sort of built up over time by adding various layers of different colours, and I think that added to the texture because it created depth. As we get to the top of the nose, I start to lighten the base layer a bit on the right hand side and darken it on the left hand side, as the reference image had a slightly lighter colour of the nose on the right hand side. And I continue the pointillism all the way up this part of the nose, but adding slightly different colours to match the reference photo a bit better. As you can now see, I'm starting to experiment with adding some of the fur at the top of the canvas, and then I decide to leave that until another day and move on to try and paint the eyes. Now the eyes for this painting I ended up redoing about 6 times. I just could not get them to look right, and sometimes it's just about persevering and leaving it a little while and coming back to it and looking at it with a fresh set of eyes. And eventually I did get there, as you'll see in the end, but yeah, basically ignore the number of times that I repaint these eyes, because first of all, they weren't the right shape, and then they weren't the right colour, and it just took a while. Anyway, yeah, as you can see, I've moved on to some of the fur. Now, to do the fur, I sort of used a mixture of a wet and wet technique, painting down the layers of the black and the white, and then using a clean paintbrush to feather through the layers. Like if you were baking, you know, you feather chocolate and whatever like that. It was basically like that, but adding in lots of texture and going back and forth between the two colours to create the finer layers of the fur. I personally think the fur was the most fun part of this painting for me. I enjoyed seeing all the texture come together, and it was quite satisfying once I'd got the hang of what technique I wanted to use. I think the sort of wet in wet technique of using the two colours together worked really well for me. And it's something I definitely would recommend experimenting with, as it's quite hard to paint each individual like bit of fur, so it's much easier to do slightly bigger and create the impression of lots of strands of fur rather than painting each individual strand, as that would take forever. I think personally for me, I found the fur more successful when it was the white versus the black, because the contrast was much better. I think the yellow ochre colour sort of made the black colour muddy rather than creating a nice like fur texture. So I think if you were to try this, maybe lighten up the base colour a bit more, or maybe paint more individual strands in. But I think it gave a good impression overall, because the white and black fur at the top corners was quite effective, and so it draws the eye to the top corners rather than the bits that were not quite as successful. I don't think they stand out as well. Basically, yeah, this painting is a lot of fur, but I really enjoyed painting it, even though it did take me quite a while to actually finish this painting. I'd say I was painting this over a period of months, because I was back and forth between university, and it was one of those projects that just dragged on, but I actually am really happy with how it turned out in the end. And I think that I've learned a lot of lessons about how to use acrylic paints. Like at the very start of this video, you'll be able to see that I spent way too long mixing really thin acrylic paints. I'm adding way too much water, and I think that hindered me somewhat. But I learned as I went through that I needed to add less water to create the right texture, and it made a much more successful piece in the end, because I learned along the way. As you might have just seen, I did paint the edges of this canvas black. I personally think that the black colour stood out much better and made the edge of this canvas come together as a whole piece. It was almost like a frame around the edge. I know some people like to continue the painting over the edge onto the edges, but personally I think for this painting it would have been too tricky, and I much prefer the way it looks with just a black band around the edge, and it sort of frames it. As you might be able to see now, I finally plucked up the courage to go back onto the nose. I think I'd done really well at perfecting how the nose looked at the beginning of the video. Like I got intimidated to bring it up to the top of the nose, and the top of the nose texture changes in the reference photo. The hair starts to get slightly longer, and it makes it more difficult to just use dots. So as you can see here, I'm blending between several different colours, trying to get the colour right and also the texture right, because using the tiny dots doesn't necessarily give the same effect as it does on the base of the nose at the bottom of the painting. For me, the key to getting this painting to look realistic was to give an impression of fur rather than focusing on painting every detail realistically. Like, of course, all the dots are not going to be 100% accurate to the painting, but the overall impression that it gives makes you think that it is realistic. And I think that's the key to painting things semi-realistically, is to give a good impression of what is there rather than focusing on painting every minute detail, because number one, it will take you less time, and number two, it gives an overall painting that will be far more successful because you've focused on the painting as a whole rather than individual components. At this point in the painting process, you might be able to see that, but the brush I'm using now is very frayed and broken, and it's a very old brush, but actually that texture of the bristles being spread apart was exactly the texture that I needed. You could probably achieve the same thing if you cut bits out of a old paintbrush, but for me this paintbrush had been flattened in a funny way and it just fanned out in exactly the position that enabled me to get lots of smaller dots down without painting them individually. I think that is a real hack that if I discovered it earlier, it would have made this whole painting process a lot quicker. Another thing that I liked to focus on was trying to blend out the edges between each block of colour that I'd painted as a base layer, and I think this really helped like make the whole piece cohesive and you didn't have harsh lines. Obviously if they're in the reference photo you'd paint them as harsh lines, but none of them were particularly harsh lines because they're fur, so I think blending them out in and making a transition between the colours really helped me achieve the more realistic look to this painting. Again, you can see me start to use the wet and wet technique I was mentioning earlier with the top middle of the tiger's head. And this was more successful this time with the yellow ochre because I lightened up the colour a bit and I was more intentional with my brush strokes than I was in the lower right-hand corner of the painting. And this created a good effect to make the shorter fur on the middle of the forehead stand out. As you might be able to see, I've just gone back in with a slightly darker shade, and this is trying to narrow the nose to give the tiger sort of a bridge of his nose as such. By narrowing it between the eyes sort of gives the impression that the bottom of the nose is bigger, and sort of makes it a bit more three-dimensional because before that it was a little bit flat. As you might have just noticed, I did just paint the eyes white. I realised that the shape of the eyes just wasn't right and it just wasn't looking how I wanted it to look. It wasn't giving that realistic feel at all, so painting over it in white and just completely starting afresh with it was probably the way to go. I actually left this painting with white eyes only. The whole rest of it was finished for about a month or two because I was so intimidated about trying to get these eyes right. And when I finally did, I was so relieved because it just brought the whole piece together, and it was like the focal point. The eyes are so important in any animal. It's what you look at as a human. And so I wanted to get this right. And so painting them in white was probably the best thing I could have done because it started me again from scratch, and I could come back to it with peace of mind, with fresh sight, and see whether I could get the right shape and the right colour. And so when I did eventually paint the eyes in, I painted it with a really, really small brush, and I made sure not to dilute my paints too much. I think that was the problem I was having before, that all my paints were merging together and all muddying up. And then I decided to add some shine to the eyes, and that really made the eyes look like they were round and shiny and like alive rather than just being flat paint. And there we go, that is the end of the painting process. I really hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, be sure to give it a like and subscribe, and comment down below if there's anything you'd like me to do or paint or explain later on in another video. Okay, bye, thank you.